गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो यू हैव लर्न अबाउट द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ सॉलिड, लिक्विड एंड गैसियस स्टेट। आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू अंडरस्टूड दैट द थ्री स्टेट्स ऑफ मैटर डिफर विथ रेस्पेक्ट टू इंटर पार्टिकल स्पेस और इंटर मॉलिकुलर डिस्टेंस। दे आर मिनिमम इन द सॉलिड स्टेट एंड मैक्सिमम इन द गैसियस स्टेट। मीन्स इंटर पार्टिकल स्पेस इज मैक्सिमम इन द मिनिमम इन द सॉलिड स्टेट और मैक्सिमम इन द गैसियस स्टेट। द ऑब्वियस क्वेश्चन विच स्ट्राइक्स इन आवर माइंड दैट कैन मैटर चेंज इट्स स्टेट। द आंसर इज यस, अ मैटर कैन चेंज इट्स स्टेट। देर आर टू फैक्टर्स विच चेंज द स्टेट्स ऑफ मैटर। बाय चेंजिंग द टेम्परेचर और इफेक्ट ऑफ टेम्परेचर, एंड सेकेंड वन इज बाय चेंजिंग द प्रेशर और इफेक्ट ऑफ प्रेशर। द फर्स्ट वन इज इफेक्ट ऑफ टेम्परेचर ऑन द स्टेट्स ऑफ मैटर। ऑल ऑफ यू नो वाटर एग्जिस्ट इन ऑल द थ्री स्टेट्स। इन सॉलिड स्टेट एज आइस, इन लिक्विड स्टेट इन द फॉर्म ऑफ वाटर, एंड इन द गैसियस स्टेट इन द फॉर्म ऑफ वाटर वेपर। दीज थ्री फॉर्म ऑफ वाटर इज इंटरकन्वर्सिबल। वेन यू heated the ice, it change into liquid water, and again when you will heat the water, it change into water vapor or steam, and if you will cool water vapor, it change into liquid water, and if water is cooled, it again change into ice. This means when a solid is heated, it change into liquid, and when a liquid is heated, it change into gases, and when a gas is cooled, it change to liquid, and when a liquid is cooled, it change into solid state. This means by changing the temperature, we can change the states of matter. And the temperature at which a solid starts melting into liquid state at atmospheric pressure is known as melting point. So we define melting point as the temperature at which a solid starts melting into liquid state at atmospheric pressure is known as melting point. It is interesting to note that the melting point temperature of a solid is the same as freezing point temperature of its liquid state. This means that the melting point of ice is the same as the freezing point of water. It is 0 degrees Celsius or 273 Kelvin. Kelvin is the SI unit of temperature. One more thing you recall, that the process of changing a solid state into liquid state is called fusion. And during the changing the solid state into liquid state, temperature does not rise because the supplied heat energy is used up in changing the state. To overcome the force of attraction between the particles, and this is known as latent heat, which means it is in hidden heat and it is not visible. And in Greek, latent heat means hidden. In case of solid, it is known as latent heat of fusion, and it may be defined as the amount of heat energy that is required to change 1 kg of a solid into liquid state at atmospheric pressure at its melting point is known as latent heat of fusion. So again, when a liquid is heated, it changes into gaseous state, and the temperature at which a liquid starts boiling is known as boiling point. The boiling point of water is 100 degrees Celsius or 273 Kelvin, and boiling is a bulk phenomenon. One point you must notice that once the liquid starts boiling, the temperature doesn't change, although it is still being heated, because the supplied heat energy being used to bring about a change in state from liquid to gas or vapor, and it is known as latent heat of vaporization, and it is defined as the amount of heat energy required to change 1 kg of a liquid into gas at atmospheric pressure at its boiling point is known as latent heat of vaporization. And again, I will repeat, the amount of heat energy required to change 1 kg of a liquid into gas at atmospheric pressure at its boiling point is called the latent heat of vaporization. But you know, some solid on heating directly change into gaseous state. Without changing in the liquid state or vice versa, and this process is called sublimation. So we define sublimation as the change of state directly from the solid state to gaseous state, or from gaseous state to solid state is known as sublimation. For example, if solid camphor, naphthalene, ammonium chloride is heated, it directly changes into its vapor, and if the vapor are cooled, it again changes into solid without changing into liquid state. I hope all of you understood the states of matter are interconversible. The state of matter can be changed by changing the temperature or pressure. So again, we describe effect of pressure on gases. When pressure is applied on gas, the particles come closer and the gas change into liquid. We can liquefy gases by applying pressure and reducing the temperature. Compressed solid carbon dioxide is called dry ice. If the pressure is reduced, it changes directly to gas without coming into liquid state. So solid carbon dioxide is known as dry ice. At last, I want to say that if you have any queries, you write in my comment box. I will come again with my next video for explaining evaporation and factors affecting evaporation. Thank you.